Welcome back, Tom.
Long time no see, man. I'm liking these. We're doing like these once a week. Now I have to, I labor all week to think about what are we going to talk about next, and I want to get this out or this out. So yeah, it's good to see you, man. Let's go. Let's have some fun today.
Let's have some fun. So welcome to another Just One Thing episode. And this time around, Tom, I just came back from back-to-back masterminds. And the question that I was hearing a lot of people that when we break out and I was talking to folks was, what's going to happen next? What's around the corner now? So you're the expert. You tell us. What do you see?
This is kind of like, in a weird way, a bizarre question, because I just wrote an article for one of the old school magazines about what's the industry like today? What happened? And, you and I have talked before about the split, and there's the mainstream industry, the chains. I think a lot of that stumbling investor groups are buying it up, and kind of that independent gem. That's a whole new world that we don't play in. Price wars, it's almost a toxic world over there. And on this side, we have the training gyms. And then even within the training gyms, you have the guys that do, the team training or the circuit training. And then you have the smaller training gyms. And then you have the guys trying to push the bigger one. So I'm looking at all this stuff. Okay. And it's just, if you look back through the entire history, and there's always precursors that kind of, if you're a writer, they're called foretelling, which is always sets you up, because you say, like, somebody opened that door 5 years ago and they would never saw them again. And then, sooner or later, somebody's going to open that door. Well, the precursors, the stuff, there's all kinds of things indicating that we're ready in the gym business to bust through to another level again. I was working on a presentation for Chris Foyer and Perform Better. And it was, I'm looking at, I was in the mainstream fitness world for a generation. I worked with World Gyms, Gold Gyms, all these guys back through there. And then I met Parisi in the mid 90s. I met Cosgroves at the late 90s, 2000. And I started to see these trainer gyms come through, and I'm like, wow, this is a whole new world on this side, but there's no business education. Nobody's talking business. And this is, guys are getting results, they're getting a higher return per client. They're working with the clients. So I'm looking at the mainstream world going, this is not going to go anywhere. There's nowhere to go. So the word, I hate to use the old word now, but pivot. It was time for me to change. I started with Perform Better with their summit in, I think, 2006 or seven, and it just put me on a new path. Well, we're there again, that the gyms really, at that point, are going to just bust through again. What are we going to see? Everybody's a good trainer. Good trainers are coming out everywhere. You go to Perform Better summits, there's 5,000 good trainers a year attending those summits. There's a generation now of, if I'm not selling training, I have to sell the experience of training. I have to sell how the training is delivered. And there's guys now starting to build that, we'll see them coming out this year, late this year, next year. They're starting to build gems based on the experience of training, not just tricking lights or something like that, but everything from the colors, the design, the little baby 80-foot mini locker rooms where I have my own high-end, like a hotel bathroom. Everything is toward the experience. It's not just what happened to the trainer. It's what did the trainer experience surrounding that training, from how we stay in touch with them using, like, your brilliant software, to how we manage them online, to how we gift them, reward them for being our clients, to how we entertain them with parties and beer taps and wine coolers and wine bars in the gym, to how we maintain all these things. The next generation gym is going to be a little bigger, meaning it's going to have to be 4,000 to 6,000 feet. It's going to be more elite. That client is that small group, one-on-one client. You don't have to have all this team nonsense. Or if you do, you put it in at a high enough level. There's several gyms now, Pittsburgh North Fitness, the Quench Training on Cape Cod. Their lowest entry into the gym, they offer team, is still $229 because it pre-qualifies the clients and they get 4 or 5 personal training or small group sessions a month. So that upscale elite gym, we talk about that, we throw the words around, but we haven't built that yet. We got the training right 10 years ago, but this guy never created the delivery system for that. And that's so the next big thing, the next brilliant thing I think is going to be is that next generation of gym that's truly built for the elite upscale client. It's how do we deliver it? What is the experience of your gym? There's such a better level to play. That gym is going to be built. That will be the gym of the future because it will own that top 60 or 40% by affluence. It will own that market that don't want to be in the big gyms. They don't want to be in the chain gyms and they don't want to be in these little 1500 foot dump training gyms. And these are the type of gyms that have the capacity to do 100,000, 1.2 a month, 1.5 a month. These are that summarize all this. I know we got a limited time on this one. If I put all that together, the big thing is going to be that's going to be your first mainstream commercial training gym that can generate $2 million annually. And I think that gym will be, we're going to see those coming out. They're going to come in big numbers. There's already guys touching those 1.6, 1.8, 1, you know, 2 million bouncing off the numbers. But building a delivery system that will get us to $2 million is what I'm really saying. But the delivery system to get us to that number doesn't exist. The client exists. The client wants to come to that gym. We haven't built the gym yet. They can bring enough of those clients in to get us $2 million a year. That's coming. That's what's next, is that type of training gym.
I think that resonates really, really well because just not in addition to the sessions I had last week, there are other people that have been talking about how we went from that model where you're looking for 300 members, each paying on average about $300, which give or take works out to be that $90,000 a month, which translates into that $1 million thing. It's now going to go back to about 100 to 150 members, each paying the magic number seems to be $1,000. And now you can own that person and then provide that total care, total support, total system solution, if you will, to that elite client. And now you're right there, you're providing a higher level of service and it's $150,000 a month to the gym, but you're providing a lot more care to that individual, if you will. So it's spot on. Yeah. That's exactly what I've been.
It's there. It's going to be there, but everybody talks about it, but nobody, the word elite, the word upscale, where we're trying to build a gym that really reaches out and owns that client. There's touches of that. Advantage personal trainer, Greg Drab and Mystic does a great job with that. I think he's pulled that. Pittsburgh North does a great job of touching that client. Quench, I mentioned, does a great job of that female only gym, but that upscale client. And the weird thing is they're home, they're looking for that place, but they don't want to go to the other gyms. They'll never set foot in these big box gyms, nor do they want to set foot in some little small gym where I walk in, I stand on the side of the workout area, the other guy finishes and that client walks off and I walk out. And again, it's a crap bathroom. I can't linger. There's no space where I can come and just, I want to be part of your family. It's just, I was talking to a guy the other day, he's rebuilding a front gym. I said, put a beer cooler in there, get a place where you can put a small pony keg of beer and put in a wine cabinet that locks, of course, but get 30, 40 bottles of wine on Friday afternoon, just set up a little bar and just like clients stop by from 1 to 4, we're just going to hang out. And they come in, have a couple beers, they sit and talk to the other members. Maybe they work out first, then they stop and have a beer on the way out. Like, why not? I want to be part of your community. So that community, they used to be the country club people. Now they're the social where they go out to eat together as groups. There are people that go to the high-end restaurants and rent the whole back space. That client is in the training gyms. We don't have enough ways to value their money. And that's what's next is to build a delivery system. It's not just the training. Every young trainer goes same thing. Oh, I'm such a great trainer. When I start training people, people are just my workouts. They're not. Everybody's a good trainer. That's the entry level. How do you deliver it? What's the experience of your training? What's wrapped around it from my contact points to my lingering ability in the gym, to the little amenities of quality of soaps in the bathroom, you know, the grade of toilet paper, you know, it all comes down to every single detail counts. And we forget that. And so we build a gym based on training. We got crap against the walls and stuff shoved in the corners and no private spaces and no place to sit. And because we're selling workouts instead of selling the experience. That's going to be a breakthrough. That $2 million gym is going to be a real part of our lives. And that's going to be a big part of it. The guys are going to get left behind if they don't start understanding delivery system and don't start thinking about the experience of this, because our clients have money. We got to wrap the training around that money. We have to create an experience where they go, yes, every dime I spend in here and more is worth it because this gym just gets me. We're not there yet.
No, I totally agree. Well, thank you once again for your time. It's so funny that you talked about that, Tom. Like, our very first positioning when we started Anomaly was we're the client experience platform, because it's like, once the more you know your client, they're the way they think, the emotional things that drive them, the, you know, whether they're vegetarian or not, you know, you just get to that level of detail about them because they're sharing the life with them. The more you can get that information into a notepad, who cares? Or in our case, in our system, so that when other trainers come in or the GM comes in or the owner looks at it, they can use that to personalize, individualize, and connect at a deeper level. That's how you build those long-term relationships and kind of
leverage. I got to throw one more thing on that, dude. One more thing. It's the disconnect. A trainer makes, let's say he's a good trainer, he makes $100,000 a year. So $100,000 divided by 12 is $8,300 a month. After taxes, he's got six. Okay, so that's, if you think about that, that's, how does he connect to a guy that makes that an hour? So what's this guy that makes, you know, $1 billion a year, that, but even the guy that makes $2 million a year, how does he connect to that trainer? Well, the trainer thinks he knows that client. You know, because if I get a car like that client, I'm going to be like that client, you know, that type of thing. Then, you know, so it's really hard for our trainers to get inside the head of a guy with money. And they almost always, because they have so little yet, that they don't connect with the guy that does, you know, you make $600,000-$800,000 a year. That kicks you into a different class of living style. And there's a huge difference between $100,000 and $700,000. There's such an enormous living style difference for that. But we don't think about this guy in terms of his expectations of quality. He'll drop $100 for a bottle of wine like it's just because it doesn't matter. It's just, I want it, I get it. They want privacy. They want exclusivity. They want eliteness. The guy wants to come in early, sit, scroll, drink some really nice high-end cappuccino. Got a cute young person behind there that's so nice and gracious working behind the counter. You know, then just the guy goes, sir, can I get you another one of those before your workout? Or what do you need? And, you know, it's just, it's all that stuff for the money guy as an expectation. For the gym owner, that's like what he pays for one day a year for a vacation somewhere. You know, and this is how this guy lives. Well, he expects you, the gym, to be part of that lifestyle. And we don't get there. That's why there's a disconnect.
On that note, we will call it a day. It's about experience. It's about connection. And it's about charging and knowing, getting into the head of the client. So thank you once again, Tom.
If you do that, you can charge more.
You can charge more, for sure. All right.
Thanks so much.